Art and culture and the making of a new Ondo State.
My name is Chief Mojumu Olatuji. I am from Ilaje. I was caught up by profession. I graduated from University of Ife. Through Adeyemi College to University of Ife. And I've been living as an artist, a creative artist in Ondo State.
Today, we take a look at how Ondo State in Nigeria is using art and culture to stimulate state economic development.
With art, one can get to where it's going because it deals with the society. It promotes the image of the society. It adds beauty to the society. It enhances human life too.
To recognize the influences of art and culture in Ondo State, Nigeria, you will have to be there.
God is the first artist that first created man using clay. So the encouragement comes from the governor of this state to encourage beauty, to encourage aesthetic development, the physical development of this our environment. So that is where the artists are able to come in to contribute their quota.
Ondo State recognize that a competitive edge and a creative edge go hand in hand to support economic prosperity in the global economy.
So that is the role we artists are trying to play through communication, through signboards, through sculptural works, through any means by which we feel we can educate people in the society to discourage people from the ills of the society. So it's a profession that we cannot do without in this our society.
In Ondo State, Nigeria, art and cultural resources can be economic assets. The art and cultural industries provide jobs, attract investment, and stimulate local economies through tourism, consumer purchases, and tax revenue.
The governor of this state realizing the importance of creativity, the importance of beauty, now added this to the physical development. Looking at the roundabouts, looking at our environment, you know it is beautiful. Akure Ondo State is no more the former Ondo State. People now cherish it because of the beauty. Beauty is not limited to human being alone. Even the environment, the type of architectural design we have, the type of road, the type of water, the bus stop and everything that we have is artistic.
The art and culture in Ondo State is offering a wide array of other economic benefits, such as helping weak economic areas. The decentralized nature of the creative industries can benefit residents of areas often thought to lack economic strength, such as rural areas and the urban core. At the heart of the creative industries are individual artists who are typically well connected to the communities where they reside. Linking these artists with entrepreneurial opportunities both inside and beyond their regions offer many economic development possibilities.
We artists, we are involved in all aspects of life, of human life, that in agriculture, in health. For example, there's a statue outside now, a woman farmer carrying a cassava with the hoe. That is a sign of encouraging agriculture in our land.
In recognition of these benefits, Ondo State have adopted a wide range of strategies designed to foster art and culture and tap into the resulting economic benefits. Also, they have incorporated art and culture into state economic development plans and policies. More importantly, they have incorporated art and culture as part of their tourism strategy, particularly through efforts that promote and market Ondo State's unique cultural heritage.
What our leaders have to do is to encourage the artists, people with creative mind. People with creative mind, they see beyond the normal physical realm. People with creative mind, they don't think of corruption. They think of how they can invent new things. That's why the wise are leading us. They don't care about all this that we are running about, material things and all the other things. They think ahead.
There is still more work to be done before the visual arts and culture can be positioned to have a significant sustainable influence in Nigeria at large.
What can we do to improve, not to rely on this, when we are the original creator? That's why most of our artworks are taken outside this country. Now we now look for money to buy those, like Festac 77 that was taken away from Nigeria. We couldn't buy it back. We have to produce the replica of that. Just see that. So we have lost the glory of our artistic value in this country. So it is necessary for our leaders to see beyond money and material things, to think about the future of the coming generation. See the thousands of products or students that are coming out from university. There's no job for them. If we are not creative in mind, we cannot think of creating a better environment, a better society for our people. See what happens in the north, what is happening like this cheaper gas. If we think ahead of the security of our people, security of our environment, we don't think of money and material things. Everywhere, before anybody come from anywhere, we have seen it. See our borders. So people, our leaders, they don't think creatively. If you think creatively, your imagination will be high. A good creative person must be able to imagine, even for what is coming up for the next 10 years. So that is the problem we are having in our country. Our leaders should see beyond their nose.
The sustainability of individual genius is enabled by communities who take the responsibility to engage in strategic planning to preserve the memory of achievements that represent the values of individuals, community, and the nation. Amoluwole Aboyade, invest in Ondo, Iselogun Share. Entrepreneurship development in Ondo State, Nigeria. The prosperity and the progress of a nation depends on the quality of its people. If they are healthy, enterprising, ambitious, and courageous.
My name is Zayof Bamifalade Alex. I'm a businessman. I deal mostly in printing and printing-related businesses.
Entrepreneurship is about people who realize new opportunities. Entrepreneurs are persistent, passionate, adaptable, and able to take risks.
Being an entrepreneur means you have your own business. You take all the risk and you take all the advantages. Nigeria, a country that is blessed with so much resources, human capital, resources and all in all forms. I believe if you claim to be an entrepreneur in Nigeria, you should be seen as a lucky man.
Business setups have become informal and oriented towards survival and self-employment.
A whole lot of Nigerian youth won't be looking out for white-collar jobs. You won't leave universities and believe the next thing to do is start carrying proposals about, all these application letters, application notes and application notification to companies that already they are overstaffed.
Nigeria is naturally endowed with entrepreneurship opportunities. However, the realizations of the full potential of these opportunities has been dampened by the adoption of inappropriate industrialization policies at different times.
The major problem we Nigerian youth, Nigerian young entrepreneurs do face, or that we are faced with, is no other thing than financing. If you have an idea and you don't have money to interpret the idea dies. It dies off like that. So if you can get an enabling environment, good source of financing, we are ready to work. Nigerian youth are so enterprising, and as long as we get those two things right, every other thing will fall into place.
Entrepreneurial potential can be found and developed anywhere, irrespective of age, qualification, experience, or socioeconomic background. Only efforts are required in the right direction.
In Ondo State, we want to appreciate God for the leadership that we have here under the able leadership of Governor Olusegun Mimiko. I believe with what he has been doing, he has been creating this enabling environment so that young men, able-bodied young men and women who are so enterprising, Ondo State youth that believe so much in what they can add as their own personal value to the development of the state. The governor has created a enabling environment, and it's just left for Nigerian youth, Ondo State youth especially, to just take it up from there and do something for themselves.
The entrepreneur is therefore an important agent of innovation, growth, and technical progress. The development and utilization of the technical and commercial skills create growth potential in micro, small, and medium-scale enterprises.
There are empowerment in the area of giving money for people to start their businesses, giving soft loans. Like the governor have his own tag for Ondo State people. Ishe takun takun, that you just, if you can work well, you will excel.
The Ondo State government promote entrepreneurial culture through initiatives that build business confidence, positive attitude, pride in success, support and encouragement of new ideas, and social responsibility.
The governor has created a very good environment, an enabling environment that is allowing the youth to rejoice in the area of their own profession. Some actually identify with the Fadama and they are doing wonderfully well there. If you want to make it, you have to work. But people that are not ready to work on those states is not meant for them.
Recent developments in the previously less explored areas of telecom, transport, hospitality, entertainment, and food processing has a high probability of success.
Nigeria as a whole can feed the rest of the world if we are properly managed, if we have the right hands that are doing the right things, and we get the right results. I want to encourage you across the globe, come to Nigeria. Nigeria is a land of opportunities. Nigeria are peace and friendly people. Ondo State especially, like I said earlier, the next commercial hub of the southwestern part of Nigeria is Ondo State.
Capital and output growth in an economy depends significantly on the entrepreneur. The quality of performance of the entrepreneur determines whether capital would grow rapidly or slowly, and whether the growth involves innovation, where new products and production techniques are developed. The difference in economic growth rate of countries of the world is largely due to the quality of the entrepreneurs in those countries. Production factors of land, labor, and capital are said to be dormant or indolent without the entrepreneur who organizes them for productive ventures.
The bad notion people outside there are having about us, that's not what we represent. We represent the very best of men and women that anybody can think of. So with people coming to join us to move this country forward, tap into our untapped resources, my brother, there is no other place like Nigeria. Ondo State, especially the southwestern part of Nigeria, it's so peaceful. We are still enjoying our age-long peace.
Amoluwole Aboyade, invest in Ondo. Ise logun se. Give me a head of